You're ready to get back into yoga, so you ordered the essentials, a non-slip mat, yoga blocks to keep balance, and an exercise ball. And you used your Bank of America customized cash rewards credit card, choosing to earn 3% cash back on online shopping and up to 5.25% as a preferred rewards member, which you put towards your most essential yoga gear, noise-canceling headphones. Apply for yours at bankofamerica.com/more rewarding. Copyright 2021 Bank of America Corporation.
This is The Bird Show.
If you are married, it is a life hack that is a must hear. If you are married, it is a life hack that must be here. Cassie.
My friends are doing this, and it is the first time I heard it. I was like, this is weird, you guys. Like, it's really unorthodox. I don't know if I'm down with this. And then I thought about it, and I'm like, y'all are geniuses. Like, this is the most, like, marital top shelf move I've ever heard of. So they have, I'm going to call it their throne room, because it's a really fancy toilet they have in their bathroom. Like, one of those ones that has heated water and the bidet and, like, can, I don't know, like, look at your excrement and tell you what you need. I don't know. Like, it analyzes it.
You
like
just
one
of those
Japanese.
Now.
No, it's like a Japanese toilet.
It analyzes your poo?
I think that's what it does. That's what it says, or pee or something like that.
Hold on. Quick Google
search. Sorry, Cass. We're going to get to the hack in just one second.
Hold on. Toilet seat that what?
Toilet analyzes poop.
Your what?
Poop.
Analyzes poop.
Or urine, one of the two. Oh,
that's actually something came up.
Yeah, it's an intelligence toilet system, and it measures sugar levels in your urine.
What?
All this stuff.
Smart toilet scans stool for blood and sugar and the whole shebang.
Oh, my God.
I thought you were going to say something else.
I thought he was going there.
I love that toilets are replacing doctors.
Right, who needs a doctor anymore?
Fascinated. This smart toilet recognizes your butt and analyzes poo for diseases.
You know what? I don't need any toilet to tell me when I've eaten too much corn.
I know I don't digest corn. Nobody does.
What's the matter with you?
You're such a smart toilet. Imagine if it...
Sixth grader. You know, such a sixth grader.
You know how your phone won't unlock unless your face is there? Like, what if the toilet's like, that's not your ass. That's a stranger ass.
It won't let you go.
Look at you. Who is this foreign ass? Trying to put your butt on my face. Get out of here.
What if it recognizes your ass and then welcomes you?
Hello.
Like Mo checks in at my house and then he leaves and comes back and uses it and the toilet's like, welcome back, Mo.
Hey, Mo, nice to have you. I will never go back in your bathroom if your toilet welcomes me.
I don't want to talk during
no,
this.
No, welcome back and your sugar levels are low. Anywho.
Okay. Carry on, Cass.
So I don't know exactly what their toilet does, but it's a fancy toilet, like heated seat, whatever, all that stuff. So they obviously spend a lot of time in the bathroom. So they have put a whiteboard up next to the toilet. So when the wife goes in, she writes a honey-do list on the whiteboard by the toilet.
With the dry erase marker and everything?
Uh-huh. Everything that she wants her husband to do that day and get accomplished
amazing.
Or that week. And then when the husband goes in, he's got the honey-do list right there so he can do anything on his phone that needs looking up or scheduling. And he can just kind of like plan out his day because the honey-do list is right there. You cannot ignore it. And what else are you going to be doing besides Candy Crush on the toilet? It is brilliant. I'm going to start doing this in my house. Tell me that's not going
to
work.
I am so incredibly proud of myself for proving to every woman that I've ever been with how incompetent I am that I have never had one of these honey to-do lists ever in my life.
They don't trust you to do anything.
No, it might be one thing like, hey, can you go to PetSmart and pick up a blah? But there's never like seven things to do on a Saturday or eight things to do on a Sunday. And then she hands you the list and then you're supposed to get it all done. Like that's your chore. Like your adult man chore list for the day.
You have no potential to help. You're so predictable in that you'll do nothing.
Don't worry about it.
Like she's probably handed over. Tiffany's probably handed, like gone to hand it and gone, nah, it's not going to get done.
Change the oil myself.
our house lives on list. Bart and myself, like together, I make a family list. He makes his own list. I make my own list. Like we are the kings and queens of making lists that we never cross stuff off.
But I'm assuming that Bart and I'm assuming that Blair also makes their own list. Like you're not making the list for them and saying these need to get done. Like Kaylee has told us that Aaron does for him, gives them the to-do list for the weekend.
Oh no, I've done that before.
You have really?
I've done a list and he adds it to his list, but and again and it keeps getting added, and it keeps getting added.
I just do dramatic things where I'm like, I can't reach it. And then he'll be like, okay, and he adds it to his list. I did have a list in our kitchen that's like a honey-do list. Wedding invitations kept getting put over top of it, so none of the things would get done. And I'm like, who put this here? And Blair's like, oh, no. Because it's another house ghost.
I am curious for the women. Do your dudes put together a to-do list for you on weekends also?
Never. I've never gotten a list from Bart.
Would you be offended?
No, he doesn't give me a list, but he knows me. He gives me one thing.
Yeah.
He comes to me and he goes, I need you to do one thing today. Yeah. And it has to be done. And I will make sure that I try to do that one thing.
That one thing.
Yeah.
Chad does the same thing for me. Like, it'll be like critical turning point. Like, you need to do this. Yes. Taxes are due. I need this from you today, please. Yeah. And then I'll do it.
I used to get those also. Like, one thing on the list, then I would do it and I'd walk in the door with that look like, are you going to give me some affirmation?
Like, I get a cookie now.
I did my one thing.
Oh, I need the validation. Yeah. I'm like, I did it. I did it. I did it. You're going to pet me behind the ear or what? I did it.
Blair does that, but he prints out the one thing on a full 8x10 sheet of paper. There's a bullet point on the one thing. I need you to do this today. It ends up on my pillow. I'm like, I got it.
It just follows you around.
I got it.
It's in the car.
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
This is The Burt Show.
Acast recommends more podcasts, more episodes, more great shows. Keep listening to hear a new show we recommend.
In a home in the suburbs, a boy dreamed of saving all the poor children off the wall. He built a charity that attracted the world's top celebrities.
Hey, I'm Justin Bieber and this is Rita.
This has become your life's work.
But behind the scenes,
things started popping up.
Allegations about corruption, blackmail.
This is the story of a charity that did well when it was supposed to be doing good. The White Saviors, a Canada Land original podcast.
Acast recommends.